Good afternoon, shooting fans, and welcome to Munich, Germany, here in the finals hall for the second final of the day, 25-meter rapid-fire pistolet. I'm Hillary Russell, and I have the pleasure of having USA's 1996 Olympic Games silver medalist, ML Milev, here with me today. Sorry, a little stuttering on your last name there.
It happens.
Welcome, ML. I'm so happy you could join me today. I'm sorry you did not make it into the final, but tell me, how is this cold weather? It's really, really cold here. Tell us how that affected you today.
I was trying to get organized before the competition. I had a bottle of warm water, had all my clothes that I brought with me on, but it didn't work.
It didn't work. It's I mean, everyone has been really complaining about how cold it is. It's been rainy, it's been windy, and it's, I'm sure, not easy to be shooting outside. And let me just go over our six finalists right now. We have on firing point six, representing the People's Republic of China, ZHANG Fusheng.
Young athlete. Every shooter from China is really, really strong, always.
On firing point five, representing Spain, we have Jorge Llamas.
I like Jorge a lot. He's a hard worker, and he's been around rapid fire for a long time.
On firing point four, representing the Ukraine, we have Roman Bondarук.
Bondarук is a quiet, nice person. I like him also. He's been shooting very strong lately.
On firing point three, representing Japan, we have Teruyoshi Akiyama.
Akiyama is one of my favorites for this final. His coach is with my name, Emil, and we get along pretty good.
On firing point two, representing Germany, we have Christian Reitz. A
seven-time World Cup Christian, gold medalist. There is no need to talk about Christian, and he's probably the favorite for this final. He's really, really strong lately in the last few years. And I like him as a person, too.
He's a really nice person. Yeah, he's very, very kind. And on firing point one, representing Vietnam, we have Kiyu Tang Tu.
That was a surprise for me, but that's what happens in cold. You don't know what's...
You just don't know what's going
to happen. If you got cold weather to practice on.
Maybe that could be it. So if you want to just go through the finals and what we should expect to see.
As the Olympic Games show, you don't know. From the beginning to the end, you don't know who's going to win the medals. And it's going to be changing in places. It's going to be probably a couple shoot-offs, I'm expecting, because most of the shooters here can shoot well. Hopefully excitement.
Well, they're all starting off with a score of zero, and then we just go into this hit or miss. And a hit is?
9.7 ring, which is a little over maybe 11 centimeters bullseye.
Okay. And more or less, I mean, we've got Reitz, who's very experienced. We've got other gentlemen here who are very experienced. But going up against, for example, Kiyu. Yeah, Kiyu, he's never made it into a final round of a World Cup before. Do you think that the nerves of entering into a final round is going to get to him?
I would expect, for me, you know, going into unknown always gets me. And I would expect, but you never know, he may be prepared for it on home ground, practicing a lot.
So basically, we have got four series to start off with.
Yes, okay. And four series to start off, and that this course carries on. And after the fourth series, one shooter is eliminated, the lowest one. And this goes on until the last two stand and the final is decided.
And in Shangwang, we were there, it was Reitz who got it on the very last series. That was amazing. You know, he had to shoot 5 out of 5 in order to win the gold, and he did it. No one was expecting it, really. I mean, we kind of thought that the other gentleman was going to win, and all of a sudden, he really just, he let him have it. And
he did the same in Fort Benning, I think.
In Fort Benning as well.
He was shooting poorly in the beginning, and then he started with a couple strings of 5, and he did it. Let's see about the nerves.
Yeah, let's see. That's right. 2 out of 5 hits for Kiyu. that's kind of to be expected when you first started, you know, entry into your first final round of a World Cup, wouldn't you say?
Right.
You wouldn't probably end up with 5 out of 5 to start off with.
It's not going to be easy start if you start with 5 hits.
You that's know, the way to go.
The pressure's going to build up.
Yeah.
That's the way to go, but the pressure's going to build up. So hopefully he will see the mistakes he made.
Okay. Let's take a look now at Wrights. He's coming off of 2 gold medals, starting off the season really, really well, winning the gold in Shanghai and in Fort Benning. 3 out of 5 for Wrights.
3 out of 5. I saw him earlier finishing his last. His arm was shaky, but he was hitting the tens.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, he's prepared.
And now we're going to be moving on to Akiyama.
Akiyama.
As I was saying to you before, for the viewers, that he travels with a baseball that his son gave to him last year when he came here to Munich just for good luck. So, and it worked for him last year. So let's see if it's going to work for him again this year.
Okay.
Nice.
Kind of hot, but nice.
It sounded like there was a pause there after his first shot.
First shot? I think it took a long time to shoot it.
Mm-hmm.
But that worked for him.
That did. On now to Bondarук. Bondarук also, he made it into the final, and I believe finished off in third place in Fort Benning. Let's take a look here.
He was in the lead.
No, he won the silver.
He was in the lead for the most part of the final. And
exactly.
Then with a couple good strings, mm-hmm. Christian got him.
Nice. 4 out of 5 for Bondarук as well.
It was stable. He was showing, you know, stability and confidence.
How often do you train, Emil?
Try to train every day.
Do you?
Yes. It's not easy working and going after work 6-7 o'clock at night. But I do it like this competition season already started. I'm trying to.
Nice. So about for maybe an hour or two every night after
couple
work?
Hours, yes. At least maybe an hour dry fire if I cannot go to the range.
Okay.
Attention.
Let's focus in now on Yamas. Two out of five.
2 hits.
And what is it that you do for work?
Me?
Yeah.
I'm a PE teacher.
Really?
PE teacher in school. Yes.
Wonderful. That's great.
Jump around with little kids all day. It is great.
Well, that's how you stay in such a good shape. You know, if you're chasing around little kids and jumping around with them too.
Or let them chase me. Yeah, that also works. Let's see what the young Chinese is going to do the first turn.
Three out of five. 3 hits. So let's just take a look at the standings now. We've got a tie for first place between Akiyama and Bondarук, both with 4 out of 5 hits. And we have a tie for third place with Wrights and Chang, 3 out of 5 hits. And a tie for fifth place between Kyu and Yamas with 2 out of 5. We still do have 3 more series that will remain until we have the first person eliminated, then go forward from there.
Nothing's decided yet, I think.
No, as we've seen in the past, you know, things can change around so fast. And, you know, do you feel like when you're shooting in a final that you get into a rhythm, or do you just, is every series different for you?
I'm trying to separate them
mm-hmm.
and go for every single one. Didn't work for him.
No.
And go for every single one with you know, full concentration.
Mm-hmm.
But sometimes the results and the right. intermediate results where you're standing affects.
Mm-hmm. And if you, like, for example, Q, who just was shooting.
He shot zero.
Zero out of five. If that happened to you, and I hope it never does happen to you, how do you get back into it mentally?
I would say draw back. You have enough time. He has enough time.
Three out of five for rights.
Three hits.
So you're saying that he has enough time to...
He has enough time. Just pull back. Try to relax completely. Eliminate the surroundings. Like
Akiyama.
Like going to his nice mental place, mm-hmm. and maybe go back into the final again after a couple of minutes of...
Okay.
Just withdrawing. Get a new approach.
Let's just take a look here at Akiyama.
He's in the lead so far.
Yes.
Attention.
So that baseball seems to be working for him. Wow, five out of five. That's the way you do it. That's the way you climb up the scoreboard and
nice.
Put distance between yourself and competitors. Excellent work there from Akiyama. Do you feel like you have pressure if you get five out of five? You were saying that.
To me, that gives me a little wings, mm-hmm. you know, and this can carry the next string as well, you know, build the confidence and help.
Attention.
I think help more than
the other way.
Yeah.
On now to Bondarouk. Three out of five.
Bondarouk, three hits.
I have to say, this week has been fantastic with all the people that have been coming to the finals hall and watching the finals. I mean, it's been standing room only, which is really great for the sport. And I had a feeling that today, because this final was so late and the weather's been so miserable, that people are going to be going home. But we have a nice group of people here.
Yeah, this was always one of the most interesting finals,
mm-hmm.
rapid fire.
Two out of five, and you can see that Yamas is not at all happy with this result.
Yeah, he's putting some distance behind, in front of him.
And now on to Chang. I have a feeling that Chang is going to be trying as hard as he can. You know, he just placed fourth in Fort Benning, just missing the podium. So I'm sure that he's quite hungry for that at this point. Oh, five out of five hits for Chen.
Right.
And that's moved him right up to second place. We have Akiyama holding on to first place by himself with 9 out of 10 hits. Chang with in second place with 8 out of 10. Bondarouk holding on to third place with 7 out of 10. And it's just Kiyu that seems like he's having a little bit of a difficulty with only 2 out of 10 hits.
And he's going to have a hard time coming back.
Yeah, that's very, very difficult, especially with this two more series remaining before the first elimination is. But even if he doesn't make it through this and it's the first one to be eliminated, you still have to take your hat off for the guy. He made it into the final.
He did.
And this will be a good experience for him for the future.
One.
Something is off.
He
may have a hard time with the lighting as well.
That could be.
Because his shooting seems consistent, good rhythm. I don't see big shakes in the gun, but who knows?
Rights.
Okay, let's focus in now on rights. He's coming off of 3 out of 5 hits. He's already, you know, bagged 2 gold medals this season, so maybe it's time for him to pass it on to somebody else, although I'm sure that he has no intentions of doing that.
He's not letting it easy.
three out of five again.
Right, three hits.
Nice, good freedom.
And now on to Akiyama, coming off of five out of five.
Akiyama.
Let's hope the baseball's there for him.
I think things like that are really nice, you know? And it probably just brings him right back, like you were saying, to that nice place in your mind. And, you know, just having some time to think about probably his family and what's coming up for him in the final. Two out of five for Akiyama.
Two hits.
That sounded a little bit strange. It sounded like there was a pause after the second shot.
I guess that's his rhythm because that's the third time he's doing it.
Right.
And it's a little bit odd for me.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it doesn't sound rhythmical and it's hard to say. We'll see the next one.
That's right. On now to Bondarook, who's coming off of three out of five hits. Four out of five.
Oh, that was a that zero, was so it's going to be three.
What did you say? Sorry?
He missed. He was overtime.
Bondarook,
I think.
Okay.
Overtime. Three hits, minus one hit.
That's a penalty.
That's too
shot.
Bad, yeah. Why don't you go over and explain how much time they do have?
It's 4 seconds. Yeah, it's called 4 seconds. Actually, if you shoot just before 4.2, for the most part, you're going to make it.
Okay.
I think the target closes, stops working at 4.3, and there is a tenth of a second for the round to get there.
Okay.
What I think happened with Bondarук was his finger. He didn't release.
Yeah, that sounded like it was going to be five out of five hits.
Yeah. Either or, yeah. It was confidence swing.
Chang.
Okay, moving on now to Chang. He finishes off the last series with a perfect five out of five. Let's see how this series goes for him.
Attention.
I find it interesting that Chinese shooters, they don't cover up one eye. They, in general, I'm not saying all of them, but two out of five for Chang. That both eyes are open, not one eye is closed, and they're focusing in on that. Do you suppose that's just the way that they are trained?
I tried before, two eyes. I can't. And I know a couple of shooters that've done this. Could be you have something in the eyes that helps you do it.
Okay.
I'm thinking.
Akiyama is still holding on to first place by a one-hit advantage over Bondarук and Chang, who are tied up now for second place. And tied up for fourth place, we have Yamas and Wrights. Kiyu has 3 out of 15 hits.
Kiyu.
And after this series, I have a feeling he's going to be eliminated.
He's, yes.
Yeah.
Hopefully, he's going to clear his mind now.
Right.
Knowing it's over. Mm-hmm. Just one good string. It's going to give him that confidence for next time.
So, Emil, have you shot on this shooting range in the finals hall?
Yes.
Here in Munich?
That's where I won my quarter place a couple of years ago.
That must have been a really exciting day for you.
It was.
Yeah.
It was hard going against Schumann, and I think Czech guy.
Podraski?
No, the other one. Sternat.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, it was hard. We were head to head, and we shot a couple shoot-offs.
Mm-hmm.
So it was exciting. Just his gun is not moving right.
Three,
either hold or...
It's 3 out of 5. He's consistently shooting 3 in every series. On Akiyama. Now to Akiyama. Akiyama, who is currently holding on to first place.
No time for mistake, though, mm-mm, right now. Let's see how the rhythm's gonna go.
Four out of five hits.
I would say that's his technique.
Yes, yeah. Technique. It seems like he really shoots really fast towards the end and a little bit slower at the beginning.
Taking his time, mm-hmm, to aim.
Bondaruk.
On to Bondaruk. He's coming off of 3 out of 5 hits before.
Attention.
Two out of five.
Something happened after the second shot.
You could hear it. You could hear like a little hiccup in his shooting.
He called it right.
Yamis.
On now to Yamis. Yamis is coming off of a perfect string, 5 out of 5.
He needs at least 4. Stay within the range.
Let's hope that he can do that. 2 out of 5.
Two hits.
Again, now on to Chang.
I think he's shooting, Yamis shooting a little bit too fast.
It sounds like it is, yeah.
Chang.
Chang has been a little bit all over the place here. He's starting off with 3 out of 5, then 5 out of 5, now 2 out of 5. Let's see what this last series before elimination has in store for him.
Attention.
He looks calm.
He does. Four out of five. I guess you're right. He was quite calm.
Yes. It sounded shaky and like broken rhythm, mm-hmm, but worked for him.
So unfortunately, we're going to have to say goodbye to Kiyu Tang Tu from Vietnam. Did a great job for getting into the final today. And
in first place.
Exactly. So we're just going to have to see what happens in his future, and we'll hope that he can make it into future finals. Let's take a look. Akiyama is still holding on to first place by 1 target advantage. Chang is in second place now with 14. And Bondaruk is tied up for third with Wrights. Now, this is when generally Wrights puts the power on.
Right, mm-hmm, yeah. Fifth, sixth string.
Attention.
Four out of five for Wrights. Right. He's broken that pattern of 3 out of 5, and now with 4 out of 5. He's become more serious, I think, in the last few years. Before, if he had a bad string, he would just kind of shrug and laugh it off, and now things have changed for him.
Probably higher goals,
yeah.
I guess.
More mature. Okay, on to Akiyama, currently in first place, just by one hit.
Nice.
And 5 out of 5 is exactly what he needs to stay in first position.
Looks like the baseball is the way to go.
I think you're going to have to ask your son for a baseball when you go home, Mel.
Yes. I was trying always to stay away from artifacts and
mm-hmm. good luck things. Charms. Or
yes. Yeah? Yes. Kind of. I was thinking always, that's me mm-hmm. who's working. But you never know.
You never know. It could just come right down to a baseball. Three out of five for Bondarok.
Three hits.
Now it's Yamas who is in the hot seat right now. He is the next one that looks like could very easily be eliminated. Yamas.
And it's 3-2 tie with Zhang.
No, because Chang still has not.
He needs 4 to tie the Bondarook.
Right. He's got it in him. I know he does. You know, he's made it into so many finals. 2 out of 5 is not going to do it.
So he's out.
Mm-hmm. And on to Chang now, coming off of 4 out of 5.
Attention.
With 2 out of 5 hits.
He's still into it.
So we have the next gentleman who is going to have to leave today. We have Jorge Yamas from Spain.
Good job again today.
AKIYAMA still in first place. He has a nice 4-hit advantage over Wrights and Chang, who are now tied up for second place. And Bondarok now is in fourth place. But it's really anybody's game as far as second, third, and fourth position go of who will be the next one to be eliminated.
And you never know about first either.
That's true. You can have just one bad string, and that can send you right down to the bottom of the scoreboard. If you had to put your money on somebody, who would you do?
That's hard to say. I would say AKIYAMA after that string of right.
I was going to say, you hesitated on that. That's not fair, Bill.
I was waiting to see. I always think that he can pull it off,
mm-hmm.
but something's not right today.
AKIYAMA.
And he looks more and more confident.
He does.
Right now.
It just seems like nothing is facing him at all.
Attention.
Unbelievable. Really unreal shooting, yeah. You know?
Good shooting.
Pressure is really on now, Bondarok. He needs 4 to tie up with Wrights and 5 to overpass him.
And with 3, he needs to pray for bad string from Zhang.
Exactly.
Good five.
5 out of 5. That has taken him above Wrights by 1 hit. On now to Chang. He needs 3 out of 5 to tie up with Wrights. 4 out of 5 would knock Wrights out of today's final. only 19 years old. And he's got a whole future in front of him. Unbelievable, huh?
Yes. He shook it off. Nice.
Four out of five. And that is enough to bump. Christian Wright's.
Throw him off.
So we're going to have to say goodbye to Christian Wright's. He has won two golds this season. So it's nice for him to pass it on and let somebody else be on the highest step of the podium.
I don't think he did it voluntarily.
I don't think so either. But we've got Akiyama still in first place by 5-hit advantage. Bondarook is in second place, tied up with Chang.
Akiyama.
So this is going for the bronze right now. All right, tell me, before they start shooting, who do you think is going to make it to the bronze?
I'm thinking Bondarook.
Mm-hmm.
Experience over energy.
Again, on to Akiyama, who's shooting a fantastic final. Three out of five. He can afford that.
Yes, I was about to say.
Yeah.
He's well.
On now to Bondarook. Bondarook, who just won the silver in Fort Benning. Let's see if he can do it again here in Munich. Four out of five for Bondarook.
Always a good string.
That is good.
Always.
That's a really good string because this means that Chang now has got to have a perfect 5 out of 5 to overtake him, 4 out of 5 to tie him up, and then we go right into a sudden death shoot off.
Attention.
I think he can do it.
I think so, at least four. Nice. Five.
Unbelievable. Five out of five.
So along with my prediction of a couple shoot-offs.
So we have our bronze medalists here. Roman Bondarook from Ukraine winning the bronze medal. He's coming off of a silver medal in Fort Benning and now going home with the bronze.
He's built some confidence, Bondarook, lately. He's been around for a long time. But lately I see him more ready to fight, ready to win.
Okay. And we're down now to the series that's going to determine the gold, unless these gentlemen tie up.
3 points.
It's hard to say.
It's hard to say.
But the way that Akiyama's been shooting, I have a feeling that the gold is his. Five out of five again. Unreal shooting from Akiyama. And there's no chance, no way, unfortunately, that Chang can overtake
Just
Akiyama.
Pack the pistol.
Yes.
He can pack his pistol.
Chang.
Real nice to watch Akiyama today.
He was really confident, shooting like a star. He was really, really great. And also, I have to say the same for Chang. He was placed fourth in Fort Benning. Now he has made it onto the podium. He'll be going home with a silver medal, the first World Cup medal that he has won in his short career. Four out of five to finish off. It's a really nice finish. Really, really great finish. So here he is, our gold medalist, Teruyoshi Akiyama from Japan, shooting incredibly today and going home with the gold medal. And our silver medalist representing the People's Republic of China, we have Zhang Fusheng.
and your bronze medalist representing Ukraine. It was a pleasure to watch.
It was really great to watch. Really great shooting. I hope that the next time you can't commentate with me because you'll be in the final. How about
hopefully.
That for an idea?
Yeah,
okay?
Yeah, hopefully. Thanks for the
best of luck to you.
Thank you, Hillary.
Ceremony for the 25-meter rapid-fire pistol men's event will now take place. The medals will be presented by Mr. Wolfgang Kink, President of the Bavarian Sport Shooting Federation and First Vice President of the German Shooting Federation. Your bronze medalist, representing Ukraine, Roman Bondaruk. Your silver medalist, representing the People's Republic of China, ZHANG Fusheng. And your gold medalist, representing Japan, Teruyoshi AKIYAMA. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of Japan.